WordPress makes it easy for anyone to build a website, but when combined with Elementor, you get a powerful, simple tool with 100% visual design. Hi everyone, I'm Kelly Sparks, and today I'm going to show you how to get started with the Elementor page builder for WordPress. So the first thing that I'm going to do is install the plugin. Elementor is a plugin for WordPress. So if I go to my demo site here, and then to the dashboard, and then down to plugins, and add new, haven't got any installed at the moment. And then I can just do a search here for Elementor. And there it is, the Elementor website builder. So I click on install now, and that's installed. And then I click on activate to activate it on my website. With any WordPress website, you need a theme to control the appearance and layout. And with over 20,000 WordPress themes out there, it's so easy to get overwhelmed by choice. And most of the queries and headaches I get are from trying to work out what a developer has done to a theme to get it to behave the way it is. I now exclusively use the Hello theme from Elementor, as it is lightweight and quick to load, and it comes almost empty of styling and scripts. And this is the perfect base for you to build your website exactly as you want it using Elementor. I come down to appearance and then themes. And as you can see on mine, I've got the 2021 theme installed, and this is the one that comes default with WordPress. Now, if you're working on an existing website that's already got a theme in, it's probably best not to install the Hello theme because that is going to change the way your website looks completely. So if you're starting from scratch, then definitely use the Hello theme. If not, then just keep the theme that you've got and see how you get on. So click on Add New. Type hello in here in exactly the same way as we did in the plugins. And this is it, the one with the palm trees. So I click on install and activate, exactly the same. And now if I go back to my website, it's got no styling at all apart from this pink color, and it's ready for me to create everything I need to using Elementor. And now to start using Elementor, I'm going to create a new page. So I go to pages and click on add new, and I'm going to create a home page. So just type home in the top there, and you can save it to draft if you don't want it live on your website, or you can click publish if this is just a demo site or one you're building. So I'm just going to click on publish there. And then at the top here, you can see this button that's called edit with Elementor. So if I click on that, then it's going to take me into the Elementor page builder. And I can see my website exactly as it looks. So this is the Elementor workspace. And on the left-hand side, you've got different controls here. And here in the middle, you can see where it says drag widget. So these are your widgets, and this is where you can put them. And when you first start a page, you've got two options. You can start it from scratch by adding a new section. So let's just do that. And you can select your structure. So if I wanted two columns, one column, and you've got all of these different options for columns. So let's say I just want one column for now. And then it's as simple as dragging in the controls over here. So I wanted a heading, let's drag that in. And anytime you want to get back to the controls, you just click on these little squares up here. If I wanted to add some text in, I could just drag that in. I can create a new section by clicking on the plus here or clicking on the plus down here. And I can add in images and everything like that through here. There is a pro version and a free version of Elementor. So these elements here, which are actually enough for most basic websites, are included in the free version. And then the paid for widgets are shown here under the pro category. So if you wanted a blog portfolio or posts or a gallery on your form, then you would have to pay. But I think it's like, at the time of recording this, it's $49 for a one site license. So that's not that much at all. So, but you can get started with the free version and then upgrade if you're enjoying it. So every widget that you add in has some settings over here on the left. So if you click on it, then you can see that the settings change. This is a text editor, and it says that edit text editor. Or if I click on the heading, then I'm changing the heading. So within here, I can change things like the colors in the style section. I can change the typography. So I can choose which font I want it to be. and the size as well in there, and things if I want it to be uppercase. It's all pretty self-explanatory. If I want to make it bigger, I can just drag this. And as you can see, it's very visual. I can see exactly how it's going to look on my website. Okay, but this is very plain and you don't want to really start your website from scratch like this. So what I suggest is that you click on this little folder icon, which allows you to use the templates provided with Elementor. And there are different types of templates. So you can have blocks, which are just sections of a page, or you can also use a full page template. The free version of Elementor comes complete with some templates. These ones without Pro are free, and there's a lot more as you scroll down. And the ones with Pro against them are the ones that are only available in the professional version. So if I search for home here, because I'm adding a home page, then I can see lots of different templates. And if I click this little plus magnifying glass, then I can see exactly what this page is going to look like. And I can go through and look at a few different ones. Go back to library. I can look at this hotel one. See if that's one that I like. Go back to library. And I can also filter this list. If I was searching for a specific business, so for example, if I was a restaurant, I could type restaurant in there, and then it will filter it to show me everything with restaurant in. And you can see here with the pro version that there are different pages for all the different things that you could need within your website. So for example, this is a Japanese restaurant, and I've got a home page there. I've got a chef's menu, bar menu, about page, a gallery page, events, and a reservation page. So if you bought the pro version, you could use each of these templates, and you know that your website is going to look very professional straight away. Kind of like a theme in the traditional sense for WordPress, but super, super duper easy to edit. So let me show you how to edit. Let's go back, search for home again. And I'll find a free template so that I can show you. Scroll down. Okay, so I quite like the look of this one. Imagine if I was a law firm, then that would be perfect. So again, I can click that to look at it, or I can click insert, and that will then insert that into my page. And if I click down here, can you see this little eye? This allows me to preview my page. So as you can see, it's created all these different sections for me. And that looks really professional. But at the top here, I've got this logo that isn't set up properly yet, and also the home page as a title, which doesn't look right. So to get rid of those, you can click on settings. Here we've got hide title. So if you say yes to that, then that gets rid of the home at the top. And then under page layout, if I change that to Elementor Canvas, then that's gonna get rid of the header for me as well. So if I click on update, then that's all saved. Come back here and now look at that, super professional. Now you can see that this page is made up of sections. So if I click on that, you see it says edit section there. And if I scroll down, there's each of these different areas is a section. So we've got practice areas, then we've got an about section, and then the firm partners. And then right at the bottom, a contact us. And then down here, I've got the option to add more sections if I want to. So if there was something that I didn't want on here, so say, for example, there was only one firm partner, just Gillian, then I can just click the cross next to these two, and that deletes them. If I wanted to change the font color, then I could just say click on practice areas there. The content tab allows you to change the content within the particular widget, and then the style allows you to change how it looks. So say I'm not keen on this brown and I want to make it more of an orangey brown, for example, then there you go, I can do that. A great shortcut is that if I copy that, I can then come down and paste style. So instead of saying paste, I click paste style and it's copied the style from this one down to this one. And then I can make that back into the center if I want to, like that. I can change the text by either just typing into the box or typing over on the left-hand side here as well. And everything is editable, basically, super easy. And to change a picture, you just click on the picture that you've got. And a top tip for this, if you click on it and look at the image in the media library, you can see the size of it. So this one here is 500 by 500 pixels. So if you create an image that's the same size as that, you know it's going to look just as good as the one from the template. So say it wasn't Jillian, it was this guy here, then I can insert that. Simple as that, I change the picture. Now, if there was another section I wanted to add onto this page, then I can just scroll down to the bottom, click on the folder to add template, go to blocks, choose the type of block that I want. So say, for example, I wanted to add a subscribe to newsletter at the bottom, then I could scroll down and there we go. We've got get the demo. So I could insert that one in there. And it's giving me a form to subscribe, and I can then just come in here, change this. Subscribe to newsletter and set up the form here. So by clicking on the form, I can change the fields. I can click and drag. You see how visual it is. It's super cool and really easy to use. I can come down and choose what I want to happen after submit. So this is a bit beyond the scope of this video, but I will do another video soon on how to customize forms. So keep your eyes peeled for that and make sure you subscribe. If I want to make sure it's the exact same font as these, remember I can just come up, do a copy, and then I can do paste style. That's the only thing to be careful of when you're using blocks from different templates. They might not be the same fonts or colors that you've used so far. There's so much that I could show you, but one thing that I really need to show you in this video is the responsive mode. So if down here, you see this icon, responsive mode. If I click on that, I can change it. So at the moment I'm viewing it in desktop mode, but I can change it to tablet or mobile. So if I change it to tablet, it makes it look like a tablet. And as I scroll up, it shows me how it's gonna look on a tablet, and then I can click on mobile and it shows me how it's going to look on a mobile. So super duper easy. And if I want to change something, then not everything is customizable for the different views. So if I click on here, for example, and click on style, anything that I can change has got this little mobile view next to it. So if I change it in here while I'm viewing the responsive mode for mobile, it will only change it on the mobile. So if I want to just make sure that that space is moved up a little bit, or I could make it much bigger on a mobile, for example. So say I wanted it like that. If I then change it back to desktop, you can see it's gone back to the size that it was. They're all the same. Tablet, they're all the same, but then on the mobile, the one that I changed to start with is bigger. So just not everything is customizable, but it's all the ones with the little mobile icons next to it. So if it's got a mobile icon next to it, you're safe to change it. And when I'm finished, I just click on update. And that's it, my page is saved. And to come out, I can click on that and click on exit dashboard. I hope you've got a clearer understanding of what Elementor can do for your website. It's an excellent tool and I use it within my websites and also use it to teach my students in the website formula course. I've only just scratched the surface of what you can do with Elementor in this video, but I will be releasing lots more tutorial videos on it in the future. So make sure you like and subscribe, and I will see you soon.